Okay, so our Dyson has failed, the Dyson cleaner. It's actually this one here, which I believe is a V7. Is it a V7? So I've actually replaced the battery anyway and put a, yeah, V7, put a third-party battery on. That's made a world of difference. I also cleaned out the entire mechanism and all this compartment here, and there's actually a filter in here which I didn't realize, and wasn't actually in the instructions, I don't think, because it's not supposed to come off, but you can actually get this off. There's a foam filter inside which I've cleaned out. Anyway, that's done, and I'd say the machine is working again. But this is the old battery. I'm just curious to see what's inside, really. I mean, it has a switch here, which is actually pressed down by the trigger in the machine. So as you pull this trigger, it operates a plunger that comes down. It's actually quite a thin piece of plastic, but this red button has got an extension to it, which actually operates that push button here. But in the case of this battery, even with the button down, I get no volts on these two contacts here. I'm not sure whether that's correct, or there's some other interlock somewhere, but so it certainly doesn't produce any power at all. And even when it finally became sort of unacceptably bad, the capacity of the battery was clearly failing, so it needed to be replaced. So the official Dyson replacement was something like three times the price of that third party one, and the third party one seems to be working fine so far. We've had it well over a month now, and it says doing just fine. So yeah, I think Dyson are obviously getting away with charging the premium. Anyway, this battery's got some screws in it. So I've taken these two screws out. There's a screw here as well, which I haven't taken out yet. They're all Torx 8s, I think. Yeah, so this wearer set, which is excellent, by the way. I thoroughly recommend these. This is a T8, and sure enough, fits perfectly. Interesting screws, say Torx 8 with quite a coarse thread that I guess is designed to dig into the plastic as a self-tapping screw in effect. Anyway, I'm sure this is probably, actually I'm not sure, I'm assuming that it's welded together, but maybe not. There we go. So it has got clips. It's not welded, it's just clipped, which I guess we'd expect. It's just a cheaper process, much cheaper just to push it together and have it attach rather than go through a process of welding. And there we are. Nice one. So maybe I could use this again or replace the 18650s. As far as I know, there's nothing else wrong with it. So this switch is falling apart. How does that work, I wonder? Is it just a standard micro switch, or is it just some metallic leaves? There we go. I think it is actually a micro switch. So there's the switch button itself with a spring to return it, which is just pushed onto this little spigot here. And I would say that is a commercially sourced switch, maybe. So it looks as if this reaches around underneath and pulls up on that little white switch there. Yeah, that is the mechanism for operating that switch. So yeah, that's again quite impressive, really, I would say. Well, not impressive, but it's a well-engineered, say, off-the-shelf switch, which presumably meets the spec that Dyson needed for this particular application. Fairly tiny. It's got these two holes in it, which push onto the mouldings in this part of the battery case. So it just pushes onto those, which locate it positively. And a very small movement of that white button. Operate the switch. If I can see what the rating is, I can see some lettering on there, but we'll see. Meanwhile, in here, again, it looks like maybe some kind of thermal cutout or something. There's something in there, definitely. It's not just a connector. There is some device in there. Okay, so that's actually broken it, obviously. So that's a bit of a pain. Yeah, I've definitely toasted this, which is really annoyed about still. Okay. So, yeah, there is some kind of spring clip in there. I just couldn't work out where it was gripping some debris. Right, let's try and work out what this was before I destroyed it. I wonder what this is. It's a big pin, and there's a rounded end. So I think it might be some kind of thermal fuse. It's not magnetic, so I assume it is brass. So I'm kind of at a loss, really. So there's one of the black and the white wires. One goes to this kind of spring-loaded thing. And the other goes to the solid brass pin. So I'm guessing perhaps this is bimetallic in some way. And this outer steel, thin stainless shroud is what clips it into the body of the moulding here. So it's a once inserted, never to be removed deal. So the markings on this switch here say 0.1 amps, 30 volts DC, or 0.1 amps at 125/250 volts AC. So obviously they're using it in the DC mode. So 0.1 amps, it's a control signal rather than anything to do with the delivering the power to the machine. So yeah, I've never seen one of those before. I'm sure it's a standard spec part, but very neat. Yeah, meanwhile, another T8 torx screw. Bit of circuitry there, and the main power connectors back up to the vacuum. A very neat looking array of cells. Whoa! There we go. So that was just held on. Whoops! Just held on with a bit of the stickiness of this strip down here. There's a foam strip down the side with a shiny plastic outer, which in normal state of affairs, in manufacturing certainly, that would just slide in very smoothly. And then the outer cover, just clip on and pick up on these catches here as a one-time closure. So I lost something. Something dropped on the floor, which I can't find. But I think that was obviously the lens. There must have been some kind of plastic part that fitted in there to allow the LED to show through this lens here. So the LED is on this circuit board, which is deeply coated, a conformal coating on there, and quite a sophisticated circuit. A bunch of ICs on there, 1, 2, 3, 4. So obviously battery management, and by the looks of it, with all these strips here, and here and here and here, there's some cell balancing going on. So charging is organized in such a way that cells are balanced, I would think, and there'll be some thermal management as well. It's not obvious underneath this coating where those parts are, but yeah, there must be some thermal management as well as cell balancing. So yeah, quite a sophisticated setup. So all these cells are spot welded into position in a quite sophisticated way. So it would be feasible to replace them. On the other hand, it'd be quite time consuming. Probably more time than it's worth. Yeah, I mean, that could easily, very easily, be re-engineered to allow 6 8650 just to be slotted in through the side of the casing almost. If you could just take a panel off the side, pull out the old cells, slot in the new ones, all this circuitry, the switch, and all this mechanism could be retained and carry on for another 10 years or whatever it is. So yeah, a lot of unnecessary waste, which is a shame. Okay, interesting to me, but slightly disappointing. And obviously I've screwed up the, I think it must be a thermal fuse safety device. So I can't really reuse this again as it is, but I'll take the cells out probably and test each one individually and pick out the ones that can be reused again. Otherwise, thanks for watching.